Cardinal Tagle, thank you for this interview. Why do Caritas Internationalis and Pope Francis underscore the importance of welcoming migrants?
Migration is a fact of life, but in these recent years, it has become a dramatic international phenomenon. And Pope Francis and Caritas Internationalis have this advocacy of welcoming and accompanying migrants, first, because they are human beings. And through our humane treatment of the migrants, we want to show the world that this is not just a political, economic problem, it is a human problem. Secondly, we respond because of the faith, the Christian faith. Israel was a country, a nation of refugees in Egypt, and God took care of them and made them realize that God is there to lead migrants to freedom and a good life. And Jesus was very close to those who had no homes, those who were outsiders. And he even said, if you do this to the least of my brothers and sisters, if you welcome the stranger, you are welcoming me. So both a human reason, but also a spiritual faith reason.
How is Share the Journey going, and what are your hopes for this campaign, in particular for the Global Week of Action in June?
We are very happy to note that in many countries now, where the Episcopal conferences and the national Caritas organizations have picked up the Share the Journey campaign, it is slowly spreading. In my trips to different parts of the world to visit Caritas members, I am very pleased to say that bishops and local Caritas organizations, even on the parish level, have been given extra courage and motivation by the campaign. And we hope that from September last year, when we launched the campaign with Pope Francis, we hope another moment to highlight this is in the coming month of June for the Week of Action. And we have proposed some actions like having a meal with the migrants, or in the case, for example, in the Philippines, we want to gather the students from different countries who are studying in Manila. We also have found some families, refugees, especially persecuted Christians, and also displaced people, local, internally displaced people, indigenous peoples who are going to the big cities. We hope that we will be able to show the world through action, not just through words, what caring for the migrants is all about.
What would you say to those who are afraid of immigrants and to those in power or political leaders who put up walls to stop immigration?
My first word to them is, we understand that the migration issue is very complex. And so we understand the various reactions. The second thing that I want to tell them is, go and meet a migrant. Sometimes we discuss migration as an idea, as a concept, but it is different when you see a migrant, when you hear their stories, when you touch their hands, and then you realize their stories could be your stories. You could see yourself in them. And then you start sharing the journey. Thirdly, I would like to invite them also to remember, not to forget, the migrants in their families, the migrants among their ancestors. All countries in the world have had experiences of migration due to poverty, due to wars and conflicts, due to natural disasters. If we only remember how our forefathers were accepted to start a new life in other countries, maybe we would be a bit more open. But we forget, and we select our memory. But with forgetfulness, then we do not see ourselves in the new migrants.
Cardinal Tagle, you have been president of Caritas Internationalis for 3 years now. How has this experience been for you? Are you pleased with what you have been able to do?
Yeah, at first I considered this task, this mission, as a heavy burden, because I was not prepared for it. And I do not see myself as a great organizer or what. But I accepted it as a calling. And now I think more than what I can do, I think it is what Caritas has been doing to me that is significant. I am learning. This is a time for education for me. And it is not just learning intellectually. It is, I feel that I am like a seminarian again, being formed, you know, in the realities of suffering and hope in the many people who are really brought to situations of difficulty. I do not see only misery. I see in them people who are teaching all of us what humanity is all about, what it means to hope, what it means to be strong, what it means to love. No? And so, yes, I hope I am able to do something, but I want to say that Caritas and the people being served by Caritas are doing much more for me and my growth as a person.